angels, every one of them. Now, a year ago, back in the dark winter of 1961, I probably wouldn't have said that. You see, I just had adopted these kids, and, well, I hadn't any experience of being a father. So there was a lot of problems. But now they've really adjusted. And I love having them around. They're great kids. Raising them is a breeze. So I'm looking forward to a very peaceful year. Excuse me, I'm late for a redhead. Great kids. Love those kids.
He thinks we've adjusted, thinks kids are a breeze.
He expects a peaceful year. Boy, is he in for a surprise.
Having an auction to replace the books. We have to raise $7,000, so Rose and I are on the committee.
Radio not just disappeared. What are you doing with my radio?
You donated it.
I said my old tube radio, not my new transistor radio.
Sorry, Marva. Look, don't get technical with me.
I'm gonna bring the car out.
Here. You can auction this.
What is it? It's a frog.
His name's Bruce. He's very valuable.
Yeah, I'm sure he is. Here, why don't you just take that away? Here.
Here, take this. It's an original recording, personally autographed by Louis Armstrong. Morning, Bruce.
Wow, you sure you want to let it go?
It's for good cause.
You're so rich. You could just give a bunch of money.
That's right, little one. I could do that. When you go through life, you're not always going to have a guy with a big checkbook backing you up. Besides, you want to have the satisfaction of earning what you get. Like that album. How I got that?
How?
Well, Louis was playing Eddie Connors, and I was dying to see him. But I was only 16, so it was impossible.
So what'd you do?
I cut off a big clump of my hair and made a long mustache. I got one of my father's old fedoras. I went up to the stage door and said to the guard, I'm Mr. Armstrong's attorney, and I demand to see my client. Louis heard about this crazy kid out back with a fake mustache. He got such a kick out of it, he not only invited me backstage to see the show, he gave me that album. I'll get that. So when you want something worthwhile, gotta be inventive, be bold,
You gotta take chances, right?
Right.
Diane. Did you get this letter from Daryl?
Another one? Gosh, he really has a thing for you.
That boy's a fool.
Why, because he cares about me? Because
he dropped out of school.
Daryl was very good on guitar. He wanted to play professionally.
That'll be the day.
Daryl is playing in Las Vegas with Elvis Presley.
In his dreams!
See for yourself.
I don't believe it.
Wow, it really is Elvis.
Oh, Elvis! I love him! I really do. I get this neat, funny feeling in my stomach every time I think of him. You ever get that feeling, Clapper?
Me? At my age? Only when I eat chocolate cake.
Sorry, I can't take you to school. Something came up. See you later.
What's with him?
Can't say for sure. Not yet. But it looks like arson. I'll let you know what we find. Thanks for coming down.
Thank you. Lucky your driver wasn't hurt. Better reconsider Mr. Rapp's offer.
Listen, Plunk. You tell Rapp he's messing with the wrong guy.
You're a family man now, right? Got a bunch of kids. Mr. Rapp wants you to come to Las Vegas. Talk business. Think about it.
Very good items for a junk shop. That's a Don Budge signature model. Just needs to be restrung.
You called this junk Hillerman?
Oh, no, Marva. That must have cost you at least 4 Raleigh coupons.
You're a real riot, Hillerman. Let's see your stuff.
Yeah, talks cheap.
Go ahead.
That's it.
An Ulfer hat and bongos? You think what we brought is junk?
My dad's a television executive. This was worn by Fess Parker on Davy Crockett.
77 Sunset Strip, Kookie's comb.
Gosh. Maynard G. Krebs bongos, personally autographed by Bob Denver.
Those must be worth a fortune.
So? That's okay. We have something better.
We do?
Yeah. Elvis Presley's guitar.
Elvis's guitar? I paid 70 bucks for his t-shirt, 100 for his bolo tie. I'll give you 1,000 for the guitar. 2,000. I'll go into my trust.
I'd like to see this guitar.
Well, it's being cleaned, and I won't have it back for a couple of days.
Sure, Diane.
Get your money ready.
Diane, 2 days. Can't wait.
I can't either.
You lose your mind.
Why did you do that?
I had to.
Amy thinks she's so great with her TV props.
Ooh, she drives me crazy.
Some bopper one. Don't promise her guitars.
Look, Daryl and Elvis are friends.
Daryl's a flick.
Yeah, you don't know he can get you the guitar. Just give me some change. I want to call him. Thanks.
Hello?
Hi, Daryl. Hi, it's Diane Foley.
Diane, did you get my letter?
Yes, and, you know, it reminded me of how special I consider our relationship. I hope you feel the same way.
Absolutely.
Great. Then you wouldn't mind doing me a tiny favor?
Yeah, anything.
Oh, wonderful. Listen, we're having this charity auction in school, and I said we'd donate Elvis Presley's guitar.
You what?
Well, yeah, you play for him, right? I mean, you're friends.
Friends, yeah. We're like brothers. But I tell you, the thing is, I'm kind of tied up rehearsing right now, and I really, there's no way I could get off to get you that guitar.
That's okay. I'll come to Vegas and get it myself.
No, that could be a problem.
Oh, I knew you'd do it. You're terrific. Great. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Here. Is it working here? Park the man's car.
Get to Vegas. Well, I can drive, can't I? Nico, let us go.
Us?
Aren't you gonna come with me?
Definitely. Don't you want to see Elvis?
It ain't gonna happen, and neither is that guitar.
Elvis is very generous. I just read that he donated $10,000 to a child who needed heart surgery. What is a lousy guitar?
You don't even know he'll see you. The whole idea is crazy.
Okay, fine.
I will just go by myself. I'm with you, Diane. You? Yes. Remember the time that Bobby Nordlund called me a spaz? It was Diane who teepeed his house with me. Remember the other time that Marcia Epper stole my math book? It was Diane who put a mackerel in her locker.
What's a mackerel?
I say we go.
Yeah.
My truck. He threatens my kids.
Why is this guy Rapp in jail?
It isn't that easy, Mr. Foley.
I know two other businessmen he's leaning on. What's it take?
Hard evidence. We need to plant an agent inside his organization.
So do it. What are you waiting for?
We've tried. Believe me, Rapp is nobody's fool.
Use me. Got an invitation. It's the perfect opportunity.
Mr. Foley, It is not our policy to use civilians as undercover agents.
But this guy threatened my kids. Are you going to guarantee their safety? Hey, I want to do it with your help or without it. It's up to you.
You'll have to wear a wire. Tape recorder.
Whatever.
What I mean is that this could be dangerous.
Dangerous? I grew up on the Hoboken docks, fighting gang wars, dodging knives, and swimming in the Hudson.
You are never gonna guess what we're donating.
Elvis Presley's guitar.
Can you believe it?
That's great. Who's Elvis Presley?
You know who Elvis Presley is.
You know, you ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time.
Oh, right, right. Elvis Presley's the hound dog.
Get out of here.
You kids did terrific. You'll make a fortune. He's the biggest there is today.
Where are you going?
I'll just be a few days. I'll be at the Sahara Hotel in Las Vegas.
Las Vegas? Perfect. We can go together.
Go together?
Yeah, we need to go there to get the guitar.
I have to go alone. It's business.
So, we won't bother you. Yeah, we can take care of ourselves.
Believe me, I can't take you with me.
Why not?
Because it's Las Vegas. There's gambling there. And, other things.
What other things?
Other things that are for adults and not for kids.
A guy is gonna pay us $2,000 for that guitar.
I'll give you the $2,000.
We would like to earn it ourselves, like you said. Yeah, we don't want your checkbook backing us up.
You can't come to Las Vegas. End of discussion. Over and out. Understand? I knew you would. See you Monday morning.
He thinks we can't take care of ourselves.
He forget where we came from.
Let's go anyway.
Nick will kill us.
He'll never know. We'll be in and out in a day.
Yeah. He's staying at the Sahara, right? Okay, we could stay at the Desert Inn. Desert Inn is way across town from the Sahara. Nick will never know.
Yeah, well, what about Clapper?
I got an idea.
Holy. Neil Herziger, I'm Mr. Rapp's executive assistant. This is Tony. He'll be your driver.
Got a baggage claim?
This is a final boarding call for all passengers on Flight 10 to San Francisco. Please proceed to the gate.
I'm at the Sahara.
Mr. Rapp likes to make the accommodations for his guests. We book you a suite at the Desert Inn.
Clapper, stop. Miss the girls, stop. Bring them to Vegas, stop. Have made reservation for suite at the Desert Inn. Regards, Nick, stop.
Why do you keep stopping?
That's how telegrams are written, Mickey.
Isn't it touching? He can't live without you.
He's a sentimental fool.
Well, it was nice of the Gov. He knows I love golf and he's gonna line up a game for me.
Oh, what a guy.
We'll have a jolly good time.
All right! Let's go.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes. And don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Oh, Oh, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoes. Let's go again. Burn my house, steal my car, drink my liquor from an old fruit jar. Well, do anything that you wanna do, but honey, lay off of my shoes and don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything but lay over my blue suede shoes. Lock it. For the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, 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 but don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything but take over my blue suede shoes. Well, it's blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Yeah! Blue, blue, blue suede shoes, baby. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything but take over my blue suede shoes.
Do you have any messages for Diane Foley?
Just a second, I'll check.
I told my friend Darryl we were coming, so I just hope I have some time to see him.
Paging Mr. A.
Is today the 14th?
Yeah.
Ooh, I knew it! That's why I've been feeling so tingly. Oh, if I could only get to those slot machines.
What are you talking about?
It's Saturday, the Saturday following Friday the 13th. That's always been a lucky day for me.
Get out of here!
Really? Once I was in the attic of the orphanage and I found a silver dollar. Another time I was playing jacks and won 5 straight games of Around the World. Once I even saw Eddie Fisher in a supermarket. Now tell me that's a coincidence.
Gambling is a science, not voodoo. See, I have a system for blackjack. I count cards. It's mathematical, scientific. Guaranteed.
I know I can win today.
Suckers like you built this town.
Oh, yeah? Watch me. Patty!
Young lady, you have to be 21 in here.
I am. I just look young because I have a hormone condition.
You'll have to leave. Now, please, stay behind the ropes.
That was very lucky, Patty.
Simple. You buy your beets, your vegetables from our affiliates on this list.
So all I have to do is roll over.
And if I don't, you continue to torch my trucks.
Well, let's just say that we can't be responsible for any problems that you might have.
Where's Ramp? When do I get to meet him?
I'm authorized to handle this.
You want me to buy from Allardyce? I've already got a contract with Grimaldi. He's an old friend. What am I supposed to do?
He's an old friend. He should understand.
I want to see Ramp. I want some guarantees.
I can give you those guarantees, Mr. Foley. When you do business with us, you have no problems. Waitress.
You had a call from a Mr. Nick Foley, sir. He's made golf reservations for you today at 12 noon.
Oh, I better shake a leg. Bye.
Oh, excuse me.
Beg your pardon.
That's my Keno card.
Oh, sorry.
That's quite all right. These are yours.
Hi. Thanks.
She looks nice.
Yes, well, I've got a golf game to get to. Ladies?
You don't think this is my lucky day? I'll flip quarters with you. Put your money where your mouth is.
If you don't shut up, I'll put this handbag where your mouth is.
Isn't this great? The plan's working perfectly.
I want to see Rapp. I want some guarantees.
I can give you those guarantees, Mr. Foley. When you do business with us, you have no problems.
Mr. Foley, that is great. That is exactly what we need.
It's worthless. You nabbed the houseboy. Maybe a couple of front men with that. Rapp's the one we want.
Rapp keeps himself insulated.
Then we'll uninsulate him. We'll figure out some way to draw the bum out and we'll set him up.
Mr. Foley, we are not authorized for a larger operation.
Look, if we pull this off, you guys will come off looking like heroes. Wouldn't you like that?
Heroes?
All right, now tell me, what is Rapp like? What does he want that he doesn't have?
He likes girls. Blondes.
Come on, a guy as powerful as Rapp doesn't have any problem getting blondes.
The problem's his wife, Myrna. She's very jealous. Rapp's got the scar on the side of his face.
Myrna went after him with the hedge clippers.
Some wife.
She watches him like a hawk.
Well, then that's it. Here's the deal. I will throw a little party. And you guys will supply the blondes.
Mr. Foley, I cannot put blondes on my expense report.
Why not? Everybody else in Washington does.
What you doing?
I'm on my break. Mr. Greenson wanted me to wash his car.
Yeah, well, be careful with it. Right.
Jolly Rapp.
Nick, I'm very glad you accepted my invitation. I think we're going to be good friends. And listen, Neil don't take good care of you, you let me know.
Look, I've been thinking. You and I should do a lot more business together.
Talk to Herzliger.
Well, this isn't penny ante stuff. I'd rather deal directly through you.
Everything goes through Herzliger.
Fine. By the way, I hope he likes blondes.
What?
Blondes. Having a little party. Couldn't find any redheads in this town.
I need you, baby.
Who's that?
That's, what's your name again, honey?
Marie.
Marie, her name's Marie. What's your last name? Dynamite? She's something. Sure you can't come over?
It's inconvenient, yeah, but you really think you need me?
Somebody's got to take care of Miss Dynamite over here.
Sounds that way. I'll be right over.
Good.
Sorry, sweetheart. Business.
I thought you had a Cadillac, Darryl.
I did. I traded it in. Yeah, I just wanted something a little sportier. Do you want to hop in? I made lunch reservations.
What about the guitar?
It's handled. Yeah, I mean, Elvis was hanky about it. He really loves that guitar. But I said to him, Elvis, would you do it for me? And he said, Darryl, for you. And only for you.
That's great.
Yeah. I mean, there is a little bit of a catch. You're going to have to pay for it.
Pay for it?
Believe me, I read him the Riot Act on this. But as generous as the man is, he gets funny about the little things.
How much?
I got him down to 250.
We don't have that much.
Yeah, well, that's why I made the lunch reservations. See, Elvis will meet us there, and I got a real good feeling that if you ask him for it personally, he'll give you that guitar for free.
Oh, well, it's worth the drive.
later, girls.
Dara, we're gonna have to find a way to earn that money.
No problem. Just let me get into the casino.
I'm the one who needs to get into the casino.
Huh.
With you. My system works better with two.
Oh, I don't know how to play blackjack.
You don't have to. I'll stand behind you. I'll count cards, make calculations. You just do what I tell you.
How are we gonna get in?
That's easy. All we have to do is look 21.
Charlie, if you help me out, I'll pay 100 G's.
What?
100 G's.
Later, Foley. Come on.
I've got an idea. Let's go see Elvis.
Please.
Yeah, I love Elvis.
He's probably sold out.
Hey, I can get seats for anything.
I love you.
Well, why don't we go someplace quieter, you know, where we can talk?
Noise is good, Foley. Discourages people with big ears. You don't want our conversation getting out to you?
No, of course not.
Good. Blondes give me a lot. Let's go play roulette, huh?
Yeah.
Come on.
Let's play too.
I love roulette. Charlie, you're the greatest.
Very mature.
This is so great.
Coming down?
Some business trip. You see those chicks? I thought he had more class.
Listen, we better take the stairs.
Wait a minute. That guy with the scar? He look familiar to you?
No, just to me. I've seen him someplace.
You playing, Tony?
No, I'm just waiting to say hey.
Hi.
Place your bet.
Oh.
Hey, Jim, please pick up the house telephone.
Excuse me, miss. You want to be hit?
What?
Do you want another card?
She's fine.
Yes, thanks.
$19 pays $20.
What's he doing?
You lost.
Already?
Double your bet.
Well, I could lose again.
Double it.
Mr. Simpson, please come to the cashier booth in the rear of the casino.
You're good.
Yeah.
All right.
Now what happened?
You won.
I did?
Yeah.
Hey, great. This is easy.
My name's Tony.
Rose,
double up.
Okay.
I said double, not triple.
Oh, I'm hot today.
He stops there for 30 seconds and makes a round of the casino.
It takes him exactly 2 minutes and 14 seconds.
That should be enough time.
Look! Hurry! What are you doing?
I've got to find my machine.
Here's a pretty one.
I've got to find it.
Remember that Twilight Zone where the slot machine took all the guy's money, then followed him home? Think that could happen?
Shh. This is it!
Ah. Here. It's her lucky day. Where's the money?
It doesn't always happen the first time. Time's magic. Come on, baby. Sing to me.
Hey! Stop that.
Come on. I mean, it's already in. It's gonna pay off.
Now,
today is my lucky day. It's
you.
The 14th,
oh, no.
The Saturday after
no.
The
come on, come on.
Doggone it, stupid ball. Come on, darn it. Oh, come on, stupid thing.
Come on.
Oh, hello. Can I be of service?
My ball. Oh, it's you.
John Clapper. And a pleasure it is.
My name's Ruby.
Well, Ruby, let's see if we can get this out.
You don't have to do that.
There we are. Ah. Goodness new.
Mr. Clapper, you're a regular Sir Walter Raleigh.
Oh, yes. Distant cousin, I believe.
I knew you were English. You speak so beautifully.
What, blow like big guy, what?
I think it's charming.
Ruby, would you care to join me for a lemonade?
Don't you want to finish your game?
To tell the truth, I don't care too much for golf.
So the short guy says to the fat guy, if I was a man, would I look like this?
Hey, that's funny. Not a funny joke. You're a real comedian, Charlie. You should have been in showbiz.
Come on, Foley.
Mr. O'Toole, will you have a phone call at the lobby reception desk?
Hey.
I love this game! Aren't you gonna play?
No, I don't gamble. But I sure like watching you.
It's my lucky day. Maybe it's you.
What can I say?
All right, let's double up.
Let it ride, Rose. We just want to make our money and get out of here.
17.
See, I told you.
Ooh, you sure got some kind of magic.
Yeah, all right, we've made our nut. Now let's go.
I'm on a roll.
We got enough.
You playing?
Yes. Rose, that's too much. Hit me.
busted. No sweat. We'll double it, right? I want to draw.
Stand pat. We got the odds.
That was my four. I told you.
Don't blame me. We'd be fine if you left when I said. Are you crazy? What are you doing?
I lost two in a row. I can't lose another.
Stand pat.
Not this time.
Oh, man, you're beautiful.
21.
Wait, we're broke.
Look, Rose, I can lend you some money if you want.
I gotta go.
Hey, where you going?
Barbara, wait!
Where you going? Where you staying? Rose, wait a minute!
It's just a matter of time. Someone is gonna pull the slot when our money.
I saw a movie once where some guys in jail started a fight so the guards wouldn't see these other guys escape. Should I start a fight?
Yeah. That's it! Come on! Hey, mister. How would you like to make some money?
What are you talking about?
See, I got this machine I know is gonna pay off. Quarter's already inside. All you gotta do is pull the handle. We'll split it. 50-50.
Sure, why not?
That's it.
Is it okay to pray in a casino?
Everyone else does.
I promise to clean my room, make my bed, brush my teeth after every meal.
Officer, officer, can't you keep these brats out of here?
He stole our money! The one that we had from the spot! The one that we had from the spot! You remember?
We don't even have money for the hotel now.
I know, I'm sorry. I don't know what came over me.
No, you're making my job tough. Now, I'm going to tell you this, and I'm going to tell you for the last time. Stay out of here!
What's going on? This creep won't give us back our money.
He played a slot machine for Patty and won.
You won the money? $500. He can't do that to you.
He messes with you. He messes with all of us.
Yeah, he's crazy about gypsy music. Tell you, the guy's full of surprises. How's your food?
Delicious.
Good. I knew you'd appreciate this place. I mean, you're very sophisticated.
Me?
You're very special, Diane. I mean, believe me, I've met a lot of women, but they can't compare to you.
Right. What about all those showgirls?
Well, they're beautiful, sure, but they're shallow. You and me, we are artistic, creative people.
You know, when you dropped out of school, I thought it was a big mistake. But I was wrong.
People just need different things at different times. I was ready, that's all.
You knew what you wanted. You made it happen. I respect you.
Hey, what the hell are you doing?
Carl. Hey, que pasa?
I drive by and Mr. Greenson's car's outside.
My pal Carl, he's a great kidder.
Give me the keys.
Sure, that's cool.
Hey, it's your car.
Now, this particular car, I happened to borrow.
Yeah, from a car lot where he used to work.
Dale, you're a musician.
He's a car jockey. An unemployed car jockey.
You lied to me.
Not entirely.
You don't even know Elvis.
I parked his car.
You can't get me that guitar. I'm totally, utterly ruined. All that trouble, get the money for nothing.
You should talk. You were the trouble.
Don't blame Rose.
I'm not. I'm blaming you. I told you Daryl was bad news.
You know, that's really not fair, Marla.
Shut up.
Look, we can still pull this off. All we have to do is explain the situation and just ask for a minute of Mr. Presley's time.
That's a good idea.
Excuse me. Hi. I need to see Mr. Presley.
Beat it. Mr. Presley ain't here.
Well, then why are they here? Oh, I never leave. I sleep here. Would you please give this to Mr. Presley when he comes?
Get lost.
You had to go one up on Amy, right? Had to promise that guitar.
Marva, we're just 20 feet from getting Elvis's guitar. All we need to do is get past the guards.
Oh, that's easy. I'll just put on a gray wig and say I'm Elvis's mother.
You're brilliant.
You're crazy.
She just gave me the greatest idea. If you guys help me, we'll get in. Come on.
Do you need me?
I especially need you. Come on.
Well, Ruby, I'll tell you. I knew back in the 30s I wanted to come to the States. I'd go to the cinema, see all those great Yank movies.
What, cowboy films?
No, I never cared much for shoot-em-ups, but I liked musicals. Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers.
Fred Astaire? I've seen every film he's ever made. What's your favorite?
Oh, that's easy. Shall We Dance?
Oh, yes.
Remember, and Fred and Ginger have this whole fantastic number.
On roller skates.
Right.
That's my favorite, too. Remember, you say tomatoes.
And I say tomato.
You say potato.
And I say potato.
Tomato, potato.
Let's call the whole thing off. I'll tell you a secret. If you promise not to laugh.
Cross my heart.
I used to take lessons. But we're waltz, foxtrot, cha cha cha. Of course, I wasn't as good as old Fred.
I'll bet you were terrific, Johnny.
That was eons ago.
Oh, well, for me too.
Ruby. Should we dance?
can't remember the last time that I felt this way.
Me too. I'd forgotten what it's like. Is to the most beautiful woman in the state of Nevada.
You are such a lovely man. Excuse me. I have to make a phone call.
Don't be long.
Show, you might as well go home.
Oh, I can't stop it. I can't believe it. I'm going to wrap my head in plastic and preserve it forever.
That wasn't Elvis.
All right, folks, come on. Wait, let's break it up.
I him. Elvis has a mole underneath his right eye. Did you see it?
No.
Because that was a decoy. See, they get a guy that looks like Elvis, and he takes all the heat.
All right, let's go, folks. Let's move it out. Come on, everybody.
Then the real Elvis comes. Nobody move. They're trying to trick us. Elvis, that's a dude boy. Hey, everybody,
there's
Elvis.
Keep your window open.
This looks dangerous. About this, it worked.
Hey, come on.
Mr. Clapper?
Yes.
The lady wanted me to give you this.
Sweetheart?
Couldn't be happier.
Charlie, we've got some time before the show starts. Why don't you and I go talk about my proposition?
You're persistent, Claude. I like that. We'll talk after the show.
Someplace.
Mr. Presley?
Just a second, baby.
Sam. It's okay. I'll come back later.
It's Sam.
30 seconds to curtain.
Hey,
ladies, sit down. Hey, what's going on? Ladies, please, come on, please. Don't stay. Ladies, let's go. Yeah, come on.
'Cause I'd give you the money.
We wanted to earn that guitar ourselves.
Yeah, like you and Louis Armstrong.
Well, except I didn't end up on stage with Louis Armstrong dressed for a fan dance.
You said it's good to take chances.
Yeah, well, that doesn't include disobeying me, or lying to Clapper, or involving Patty and Mickey.
You're gonna talk morality? That's a laugh.
Yeah, we've seen you in action.
What's that supposed to mean?
Necking with that bleach blonde.
That's not what you think.
What is it? How could you lie to us?
Hey, I'm not in trouble with you. You're in trouble with me.
And who's that guy with the scar?
The man I'm doing business with. Stop interrogating
me. Mr. Foley. Mr. Rapp sent me to look for you.
Oh, tell him,
Charlie Rapp? That's why he looks so familiar.
Look.
Is everything okay?
Rapp's a gangster. I've seen him in all the papers.
Keep quiet. Everything's fine.
What kind of business are you doing with him?
Business. Food business. None of your business. Look. You just stay out of trouble for one day. Tomorrow we go home. Everything's fine.
Hey, you know Mr. Foley?
He's our dad.
Your dad?
Yeah, it's a long story.
Look, want to grab something to eat?
Sure, why not? Wait a minute. You realize who he works for? Hey, it's okay with Nick, it's okay with me. What about the guitar? Diane, forget it. We can still try.
Give it up, Diane.
No! No, I won't give it up. I'm gonna see Elvis and I'm gonna get that guitar. Stop eating the pot.
Hit me.
You've already got 17.
Maybe I'll get 21. I stick.
You've got 27. You're busted. What's the matter, Clapper?
You promised not to laugh. Well, I met the most wonderful woman playing golf. Her name's Ruby.
That's a pretty name.
Well, she went to make a phone call and she never came back.
Did you try her room?
I don't know where she's staying. I don't even know her last name.
Try the golf course. Maybe they've got a list.
No, it's all nonsense. Old bloke like me chasing after a woman.
Clapper, that doesn't matter.
She doesn't want to see me.
You don't know. Maybe she was kidnapped.
Clapper, if you care about her, you've got to try to find her.
Your children, you don't understand these things.
We do, too.
You want a partner, Foley? It'll cost you 10% of your operation.
It's pretty steep.
It'll be worth it. Show me you're serious, bring me 25 grand tomorrow.
Okay.
Tony will pick you up at 10. Bring you to my place. All right, partner?
Sure, partner. Bingo.
It was awfully easy. Keep an eye on Foley.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
It's an emergency.
Yeah? What do you want?
Oh, evening, mate. We were wondering whether you'd let us take a look at today's reservation book.
It's very important.
You want a partner, Foley? It'll cost you 10% of your operation.
It's pretty steep.
It'll be worth it. Show me you're serious, bring me 25 grand tomorrow.
Okay.
Tony will pick you up at 10. Bring you to my place. All right, partner?
Sure, partner. Bingo, we got him.
It was awfully easy. Keep an eye on Foley. Yeah?
What do you want?
Oh, evening, mate. We were wondering whether you'd let us take a look at today's reservation book.
It's very important.
Yeah? How important?
Oh, well, I have to return this to a certain lady golfer.
Yeah?
I think he wants money.
Money? A bribe?
He ain't exactly gonna win the Nobel Prize, is he?
How much?
$20.
$20? It's outrageous.
Give him $5.
$15.
$10.
Deal.
Pay him.
It's highway robbery.
You love her, don't you?
Well, all right then.
Don't take forever.
There it is. You see, Tillett. Ruby Tillett. The Midas Hotel.
You know, you really lucked out being adopted by Mr. Foley.
It has its off moments, believe me. Is it true what Robert said about your boss? You don't seem the type.
Me? I don't look like a tough guy to you?
You look like a nice guy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You see, you, Mr. Rapp pays me $300 a week. That's a lot of money. And I got a little brother and sister.
What about your folks?
Well, my dad died. Mom took off with a sax player. So I got left holding the bag.
You could have split too.
Yeah.
Like I said, you're a nice guy.
You know, one of these days I'm gonna make it to LA, see what the ocean really looks like. Could I give you a call?
Sure.
Oh, what's that?
What's what?
I've been wanting to do that ever since I saw you in the casino. Mr. Foley.
Take a walk.
Nick!
No, it's okay. See you later.
Thought I told you to stay out of trouble.
Since when is dinner trouble?
Not the dinner, it's the dessert. Go to your room.
I'm on my way.
I don't want you seeing that kid.
I like him.
Well, I don't. He's a two-bit hood. He's not even that, he's an apprentice two-bit hood.
Tony has to support a family, okay?
Well, that's gonna be very difficult. Making license plates doesn't pay that much.
Oh. What else is a guy like him gonna do?
Any of honest work?
You're such a hypocrite. I can't believe it. I mean, you're working with this rap guy. Why shouldn't Tony? At least he's doing it for his family, not to make another million.
Look, I'm doing something I have to do, something you don't understand.
Just trust me on this one. I'm gonna make it all up to you, Diane. Just keep an eye out, will you?
Daryl, are you sure about this?
The maintenance guy swore to me that this duck leads straight to Elvis's room.
Well, maybe I should go.
Diane, a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. Just trust me on this one. I'm gonna make it all up to you, Diane. Just keep an eye out, will you?
Daryl, are you sure about this?
The maintenance guy swore to me that this duck leads straight to Elvis's room.
Well, maybe I should go.
Diane, a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do.
Oh. Good luck!
Looks like a fork's over here.
Are you sure this is safe?
Yeah, sure.
Dylan, are you okay?
I took a wrong turn.
Yeah. Well, we're never gonna get back up that bend. Look how steep it is.
I did it again, huh?
Maybe not.
Oh my God. will take the case. We can go to a thrift store and buy a new guitar. They'll never know.
I don't know.
It's for a good cause, isn't it? But you'll cream Amy Hellerman. You'll be a hero.
Why don't you go see if the coast is clear?
Okay, let's go. Come on!
I can't.
After everything we've been through?
I didn't work this hard for a phony guitar.
Fine, I'll take it.
No.
You'll thank me for this later.
No! Daryl, I could never live with myself. Even if nobody else found out, I would always know.
Look, I'm just trying to help you.
I don't need this kind of help. It's for losers.
Oh, that's what you think of me? A loser?
That's not what I meant.
Yes, it is. And you're right. I am a loser.
No, you're not.
You got a better word?
Daryl, you're 17. You're not supposed to own the world.
Well, I don't have to be a total flop, do I?
You are not a total flop. You just got to come down to earth. Things just don't happen by themselves. You're so talented, but you've got to work at it. You're going to make it someday.
Thank you. But there is no hope for me.
You may not drive a great big car. You may not look like a movie star. But just keep trying and you'll go far. Cause baby, you got what it takes inside of you. You got what it takes just to see it through. Whoa, 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 yeah. You got what it takes.
Nice try.
What it takes, if you just try. You got what it takes, you don't have to lie. No, 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 whoa, yeah. You got what it takes, you'll see. Now all the ladies, ooh, we will beg for a date with you. Cause if you work hard, you'll see. Your dreams will all come true, believe me.
Guess you was some kind of fool.
I just think you ought to finish school, and one day you'll be standing stage and sounding so cool. Cause baby, you got what it takes.
You might be right.
You got what it takes, so it's worth the fight. Whoa, 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 yeah. You got what it takes.
That's right.
Till it. Tillett, oh, let's see. Here we are, Ruby Tillett. She just checked out. We made reservations for her.
Hotel?
No plane. She's flying to San Antonio this evening.
When's her plane leaving?
About a half hour.
Oh, well, that's that.
How long does it take to get to the airport?
15 minutes.
Oh, it's too late.
No, it isn't.
You can make it.
Huh?
Don't give up. Come on.
$25,000. Please, Mr. Foley, look after it, please. Belongs to Uncle Sam.
Relax. I'll spend it like it was my own.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Look, you want to protect Uncle Sam's money? Stay close to me tomorrow.
Okay, tomorrow, you wear a transmitter. We move in as soon as the money changes hands. Good luck.
Harris.
Yeah?
There's a kid who works for Rap. He's been driving me around. You gonna arrest him?
Everybody in the house, except you, leaves with cuffs.
Good.
Good night, Mr. Foley.
Good night.
coming down the elevator. Guy in a blue suit. Check him out.
Escape free.
There!
Ruby?
Johnny.
Wait, there comes. I had to find you, Ruby. Why did you go?
Johnny, I'm so sorry. It was awful of me to leave like that. I was frightened.
Frightened? What, of me?
You made me feel as if I were young. As if I were young and beautiful.
You are.
Oh, Johnny.
Well, why shouldn't you feel that way?
Johnny, I'm married. Bert and I have been having some trouble. He's been stepping out. I got crazy jealous. I came here thinking about getting a divorce. I met you. When I called Bert to tell him, he started to cry. He begged me to come home, to give him one more chance. After 35 years, I felt I owed him that much. Was I wrong? I was afraid if I saw you again, I'd change my mind. Can you forgive me?
I wish it was different. But don't feel bad. You've let me see that there's still fire in this old heart. I thought I'd lost it.
This is the final call for flight number 12, leaving for San Antonio.
You better go. Ruby? Tomato?
Tomato.
Potato.
Potato.
Let's call the whole thing off.
I'm sorry we made you come out here, Clapper.
Why?
Aren't you sad?
Oh, in a way. But you see, this night was very special to me, and if it hadn't been for you two, I never would have had it. Come on, give us a hug.
About last night, I don't blame you for being mad.
Yeah.
Hey, I know Rose doesn't need a guy like me, but don't worry about it, okay? Because I'm not going to see her anymore.
Let me ask you something. What are you in this for?
I got obligations.
A lot of other ways to pay the rent.
No, that's not it. You see, my dad, before he died, he owed Rapp some favors.
That's your dad.
Obligations are obligations. Now, look, you're going to be late.
Look, I'll go by myself. You stay here.
No, no, Mr. Foley, I can't let you do that.
I'm sorry, kid. I don't have time to argue with you.
Where's the kid?
Beats me.
Damn motor pool car.
Let's get it fixed.
I'll take that.
Where's Tony?
He didn't show.
Fire him.
Done.
Yeah.
Foley, your problems are over.
It's a good feeling.
His problems are just beginning. Seems Mr. Foley has friends in the Justice Department.
Do with him?
Nothing. The feds are right behind me. You bums are finished. Come on and get him.
He's what?
Burn my trucks. Threaten my kids. Come on and get these guys.
Shut up!
Get these bums! Where the hell are you? Getting a manicure? I could have gotten shot out here.
We had a flat tire.
Point it at them, not me.
They hardly have any channels here. Diane, who cares?
Marlon, that's preposterous.
Well, Nick already admitted they were in business.
Look, I have worked 12 years for the government. He is no criminal. Got this crazy idea that you're some kind of a underworld type.
Talk about that in a minute. First, I want to talk about something else. I had a good reason for wanting you girls not to come here. And you disobeyed me. You not only disobeyed me, but you did something dangerous. Now, I'm new at being a father, so I don't have all the answers. But I know this much. When you kids do dangerous things, I have to put my foot down because...
Arrested today on charges of extortion and racketeering. Federal agents credited today's arrest of frozen food king, Nick Foley. In a daring operation, Mr. Foley went undercover for the Justice Department in order to gather evidence on Rapp's activities.
Told you.
Nick, I'm sorry.
Me too.
Wait a minute, talk about being dangerous. What was that?
Really?
Yeah. Well, I had a good reason. Threaten you guys.
Oh, Nick.
You're a hero. Weren't you scared?
Did you have a gun?
Yeah.
Yeah, I had a gun right in here. And when they got mean to me, I pulled it out and I went.
There you are. What'd you hit me for?
Had to keep you out of trouble, kid.
You know, you probably got me fired. What am I gonna do now?
Another way to talk to your new boss.
Huh?
Now on, you're working for Foley Foods. Don't worry. I'll pay you what you've been getting here.
Hey, that means we could see each other.
Is it okay, boss?
It's okay with the boss. Now, what about that guitar?
We can't get to Elvis.
She's just gonna give up?
We've tried everything.
Well, that's too bad. By the way, did I ever tell you how I got Babe Ruth to give me his Yankee hat?
Carl, how does anybody lose a limo? I've got a pickup to make.
Well, I was here just a minute ago. I thought you took it.
Tell him the car's here.
Donated by Mr. Elvis Presley. We'll start bidding at
$1,500.
Do I hear $1,600? Let me hear $1,600. Come on, everybody. We're still 700 short.
Gonna pay 2,000.
Hey, I get it for what I can.
$1,500. That's $1,500. Going once. Going twice.
$1,600.
$1,600. Going once. What are you doing here?
I'm back in school.
Twice.
$1,800.
$2,000. $2,000. Can you afford this?
I can't afford a cheeseburger.
$2,000. Going once? Going twice?
$2,200.
Yeah. $2,200. We've done it. $2,200. Once, twice, stop!
I knew all along Daryl was going to come through.
Yeah, that's terrific.